Give me another one, barkeep.
Why the long face, little lady? What's wrong? What seems to be the problem?
I just don't know anymore. Why am I doing this? I had such good faith in the music biz, and I just don't know why I gotta make a fool of myself online now. Don't know what it's all for.
Well, does it make you feel alive?
Broadcasting live from New York, filmed in front of a live studio audience, it's Kaye Nite Live! With Spike Einbinder! Nick Naney! Podcast about list! Musical guest! Liam Benzvi! With Simon Haynes and the DMCA-Free band! And here she comes! Ladies and gentlemen, here's your host,
Thank you. Thank you so much for being here at the very first episode of Kaye Nite Live. Appreciate it. Oh my goodness, we are coming to you live from New York City, the greatest city in the world. There's so much to get to, and we have so many incredible experiences. We're so happy to be here, and we're gonna be here tonight. And you know, longtime viewers of this program from the earlier version of the show that was on Twitch may recognize a lot of the themes and elements we're going to be bringing to the show. And you may wonder the question that I often ask myself, which is, okay, you have a lot of good faith in the music industry. Why would you want to come online and do a late night talk show? Well, you know, it's like being bisexual. Sometimes you just need to alienate everyone around you. We've been putting the show together, and we're really, really excited for all this stuff. We're going to have a great show for you tonight. We're going to have a great show for you tonight. Spike Einbinder is here. The incredibly funny Nick Naney is here tonight, everybody. That's right. The boys from Podcast About List are here tonight. That's right. We love podcasts, don't we? And not last but not least, Liam Benzvi, our musical guest, is here to play some music for us all. We're really excited about it. That's right. We've got an incredible live studio audience. Give it up for yourselves here tonight, everybody. Thank you. Yes. 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 And this is an incredible community who fully supports me on my journey to accomplish incredible things. We are strong, we are powerful, and we will accomplish everything that we are set out to together, which is to continue to create incredible experiences each and every day. And that's what we are going to continue to do. We are going to continue to create incredible experiences for you each and every day. So let's get the show started, okay? All right. Unfortunately, they are going to make me do some headlines here tonight, so we're going to have to do that. Kanye West brought notorious white supremacist Nick Fuentes to dine with Donald Trump at Mar-a-Lago last week, prompting the former president to do damage control by claiming he hasn't heard of Fuentes. Pretending not to have a relationship with a mid-20s fascist who wears a suit to work every day, finally, Donald Trump has something in common with every white woman on Bumble in New York City. Jesus fucking Christ, who wrote this stuff? The Christmas tree lighting in Rockefeller Center happened this Wednesday, and there hasn't been this much attention on a tall, dressed-up piece of pine since the Don't Worry, Darling premiere. Here we go. The New York Health Department reported traces of E. coli and salmonella in cannabis sold at unlicensed dispensaries, forcing users to start discerning between good shit and a good shit. Are you fucking serious? While vape users are still getting popcorn lung, traditional smokers will now poop corn long. Okay, I guess I'm doing this. The World Cup is underway in Qatar this month. This week, the USA men's team defeated Iran 1-0 in a high-stakes must-win match to advance to the knockout round of 16. Finally, an American victory in the Middle East. They've lost today. Like, is anyone on? Is there a writing staff on this? What's going on? A man ran onto the field during this week's Portugal-Uruguay match carrying a pride flag and wearing a shirt that said, "Respect for Iranian women and free Ukraine." In other breakthroughs for queer people and women in arid desert environments, my pussy's been penetrated once in the last 4 months. How did you know that? I did not that's the news. All right, cool. Well, I can't take that back. We've got an incredible house band here for y'all tonight. Please give it up for Simon Haynes and the DMCA-Free Band. Hey, Simon, how you doing?
Feeling really good, Kay.
You good? You good over there?
Yeah.
Thank you for being here. I really appreciate it.
It's our pleasure.
Are you being a good boy?
I would say that I am, in fact, being a good boy.
You're being a good boy, yeah.
Yes, and I do deserve a treat.
Yeah, you're going to get mommy's little treat later?
Yes. I'm going to be...
Yeah?
Yes. Okay. Yes, mommy.
All right, that's great. Thank you. Yeah, you know, that's right. Okay. Well, folks, Simon is going to be filling that classic role we all know and love on these types of shows, which is the coveted role of the late night sidekick. So joining the Paul Schaefers and the Andy Richters of the world. Isn't that right, Simon?
Just call me number two, the deuce.
Ah, that's right. That's right. And you've got quite a setup there. What is that? That's a bass guitar?
So not only am I a good boy, but this is my four-string
bass. You've got a bass guitar there?
Yep. It's a four-string bass.
Yeah, okay, it's a great little bass guitar. Oh, fuck.
Wait.
It's Chelsea Manning, everyone.
What's going on?
What are you doing here?
You texted me over Signal like 2 days ago. You were like, "Thank you so much. This is exciting. Really glad we can make it happen. It'll be great." You know, K-Night live appearance featuring Chelsea Manning.
You know, I did say that, didn't I?
I think you were drunk.
Probably true.
Disappearing messages, maybe?
Well, listen, I wasn't the one that picked Signal, okay? That's so interesting. Well, we have kind of an issue here because Simon is the sidekick of the show.
I'm the deuce. I'm number two.
No. You can go home now.
Mommy said I'm the deuce. Okay, fine. I'll be second to the second.
Yeah.
The thing is, Simon actually has a lot of training and preparation he's done for this, and he's really, like, able to step into...
You know, I was a failed actor in 2007.
Didn't know that.
That qualifies me, I think.
I guess...
How do you think I ended up in the Army?
That's true. I mean, I guess, you were failed, otherwise we would have known about it.
Yep.
Do you have any... Do you have any improv training or anything? Like, can you riff, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess we're doing it right now.
I mean, I've done a lot of podcasts, too, unlike you.
Fair enough. All right, I think we can make this work. You know, it's very interesting. We actually happen to have a sidekick's chair there as well. But, I mean, the couch, yeah.
Okay.
It's almost as if there's, like, a specific place there for a sidekick to sit.
Okay.
All right. All right, here we go. So, this is really embarrassing. I don't know what to do here. I mean, what have you been up to? What's going on?
I have been traveling a lot. I went on a book tour, so it's been very busy.
You know, that's really interesting, but we do actually have to move on with the show. So, you know, we might have time to get to that later.
Okay.
You know, I'm not really quite sure, but, you know, if you're down to hang out, we might be able to figure this out. Okay?
I would rather go to bed.
Okay, well, you know, there's the door if you want it. Let's move on.
I'll sleep right here.
Okay, cool. As you know, I am a woman of the people. So we went to one of my favorite places in the entire world, the cultural capital of Western society itself, Times Square, New York, to talk to folks, take a look at the pulse of the culture, and ask people what's really going on. Let's take a look. Hi, we're here in Times Square, New York City, greatest city in the world. And we're gonna be figuring out what are people interested in, what's the pulse of the culture today. Let's take a look and find out. What's the greatest American band of all time?
We can't say Canadian?
No, American. We all know who the greatest Canadian band is.
We do.
What's the greatest American band of all time?
I come from Denmark.
That's a really tough question. I really like Gorillaz.
They're not American.
Queen.
So Queen are actually British.
Beatles.
So the Beatles are actually British.
The Beatles.
So the Beatles are actually British.
The Rolling Stones.
The Rolling Stones are actually British.
I have no idea. I like The Weeknd.
Kygo.
Papa Roach.
The Who.
The Who.
Who are actually British?
Papa Roach. God damn it.
Papa Roach?
Sure.
I feel like all the bands I'm thinking of are like British.
Oh yeah, The Killers.
Rush. They're Canadian.
Led Zeppelin.
Zeppelin are actually British.
Oh. As a band, it's the Stones. As musicians, it's the Beatles.
So the Stones and the Beatles are actually both British.
Get that away from me. American band.
All I can think of is British bands.
That's why it's a tricky question.
Bruce Springsteen
is actually a solo artist with a band. What's the greatest American band of all time?
Fleetwood Mac.
Fleetwood Mac actually have members from the UK.
Never mind.
Kind of half and half.
Yeah. I don't think we've ever had one yet. I think we're about to get one. Who knows?
We're about to get one. What's the greatest American band of all time?
I don't know. I gotta think about this.
Wu-Tang Clan.
Kings of Leon.
Metallica.
What about you?
Dave Matthews Band.
The Jonas Brothers.
Jonas Brothers.
ABBA.
So ABBA are actually Swedish.
I know.
I'm just going to say Big Time Rush.
Big Time Rush. Can we get a solo real quick?
The Eagles.
So Callahan already did this Eagles bit. This footage is completely unusable. Anyway.
Oh my God. Foo Fighters? I love Foo Fighters.
I don't know. That's a really tough question, actually.
Yeah, it is.
Soundgarden. We have Destiny's Child. Then we also have definitely Linkin Park.
Here's another question for you. What's the greatest American brand of all time?
Brand? Coca-Cola.
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 McDonald's.
Why McDonald's?
Because it's all over the world.
That's correct.
Maybe Levi's.
Levi's.
Levi's is a really good brand.
Levi's.
I guess Levi's.
Levi's.
Everybody wanted Levi's jeans.
What do you mean brand?
Brand name.
Bruce Springsteen.
Or Levi.
GMC.
GMC.
M&M's.
M&M's.
Ben and Jerry's.
Wow.
Ford.
Ford.
Nike.
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 I don't wear Nike. Nike, I guess.
Nike.
North Face. Patagonia. Nike. I'd say Nike.
Okay. Sure. Well, is it Patagonia or is it Nike?
It's Nike.
One last question for you. Who's the greatest female solo artist of all time?
Janis Joplin, maybe.
I'm gonna have to probably go old school raga, Janis Joplin.
Janis Joplin. Everybody loves Janis.
Celine Dion.
Celine Dion's actually Canadian.
Joni Mitchell.
Joni Mitchell's actually Canadian.
Wow, that's heartbreaking.
Isn't it?
It is. It's
not one of us, is she?
No.
What's the greatest American female solo artist of all time?
Shania Twain.
Shania Twain's actually Canadian.
Oh, is she? Damn. Miranda Lambert.
Miranda Lambert.
Taylor Swift.
Wow, Taylor Swift.
Probably Taylor Swift.
Whitney Houston.
Whitney Houston.
Whitney Houston.
Whitney Houston.
Whitney Houston.
Taylor Swift.
Whitney. Taylor Swift.
Whitney Houston.
Whitney Houston. Taylor Swift.
Ariana Grande.
Ariana Grande.
I can say Miley Cyrus.
Miley Cyrus. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Miley Cyrus.
So my husband's answer would be, based on vocals alone, he would say Miley Cyrus, because he's a singer.
What would your answer be?
My answer would maybe be Whitney Houston.
Whitney Houston.
Carrie Underwood.
Carrie Underwood.
Madonna, maybe?
No one's saying Beyonce. 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 Beyonce.
Beyonce. Beyonce. Beyonce.
Beyonce. Right, Beyonce.
Beyonce's the queen.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Beyonce.
I guess Beyonce.
Beyonce!
Beyonce.
And there's female singer. Greatest, you're saying greatest?
Yeah, I
Supremes, what's her name? No.
All right, cool, thank you so much, I really appreciate it. What's the greatest American female solo artist of all time?
Go get.
I'm sorry?
You.
I am the greatest American female solo artist of all time.
Gotta be Shania Twain.
Canadian. So Shania Twain and I actually have the same birthday.
Oh, really?
August 28th.
She's August 28th. You know, Shania were friends. We went to school together years ago.
Really?
Yeah, up in Northern Ontario.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Are you a fan of her music?
I am. I love her, yeah. Yeah. I wanted to marry her. She wouldn't have nothing to do with me.
What do you think about that?
He's a bullshitter.
You're goddamn right.
God, I was like, yeah. Hands up, sing my song.
Miley Cyrus.
Oh, no, I don't want to sing Miley Cyrus. I don't know. I can't say.
We can't say.
Okay, I gotta say something. Evelyn Champagne Campbell.
God bless, have a good one.
Can I see this?
Yeah, K-Night Live.
Bye guys, thank you.
Thank you so much.
You know Medium Bill?
Yeah, I went to high school with him.
Wow, he's doing well for himself, right?
It's a big deal.
Yeah, very good. Yeah.
And I'm here in Times fucking Square answering questions about music.
Right on.
Oh man, you hit me with that. Aretha Franklin.
Great answer. What's the greatest American band of all time?
The Eagles.
Even the Brits. What's the greatest American brand of all time?
The Eagles.
What's the greatest American female solo artist of all time?
I don't know.
Aretha Franklin.
No.
Not Aretha Franklin.
No.
Fair enough.
We're gonna go.
Have a good one. Fucking racist. You ready to party? Y'all ready to party?
What's this for?
This is for K-Night Live.
K-Night Live.
What's the greatest American band of all time?
Young L.A.
Same, Young L.A.
No, let me think. Let me answer truthfully.
You're saying your friends were not answering truthfully.
Yeah. They were fucking with you.
What's the question?
Favorite band.
No, what's the greatest American band of all time?
Greatest American
Green
band.
Day.
Green Day. What's the greatest American brand of all time?
Oh, Young LA.
Young LA.
Young LA, easily.
Young LA. What's the greatest American female solo artist of all time?
Ooh.
Rihanna. T-Swift.
Of all time. We're talking about, I mean, that's modern day. You could go back.
Dion. You got Celine Dion.
Celine Dion's actually Canadian.
Lady Gaga.
Oh, okay. Lady Gaga. Yeah, that's a good one.
Great performer. Too.
Lady Gaga. What's the greatest American band of all time?
Oh, greatest American band.
Not the fucking Beatles.
Well, they're British.
Yeah, they're awful.
Beatles are awful.
Crosby, Stills, and Nash.
Not Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young?
No.
What's the greatest American female solo artist of all time?
Amy Winehouse.
She's British.
Gwen Stefani.
Gwen Stefani! Gwen Stefani is married to Blake Shelton, who she met on the set of The Voice. And we love Gwen Stefani, don't we? Naked Cowgirl, Naked Cowgirl. What's the greatest American band of all time?
Steely Dan.
That's the correct answer. Thank you very much.
Well, I saw them live before they made it. I lived right in the building, 8th Avenue and 54th Street. It was a recording studio, and they did a song called Brooklyn Rose, Steely Dan.
Well, the next question I was going to ask you is, who's the greatest American female solo artist of all time? But I think we know the answer to that. It's the Naked Cowgirl.
Look at my song, I Love Dick.
I love dick too.
Oh, good. I might go back to stand-up comedy.
I would love to see that.
K-Nite Live. Yeah, we'll get like Netflix or something.
We're going to get Netflix or something.
I think you're very talented.
Thank you very much.
You know, you look great. I can definitely see you on television.
You can see him on List of Spooky, streaming now on HBO Max. New York Times called it one of the best shows of 2022. Please give it up for Spike Einbinder.
I can remember. That's all I know. It was raining today in New York City. It's good. The rain cleans all the scum off the streets, washes it down the gutter. Woke up today, pulled aside my curtain, see a brick wall. I look in the mirror, it's broken. So I'm just looking at one bottle of Advil. And it's empty. I live on the 14th floor of a 13th floor walk-up. I go down 10 flights of stairs and then I have to jump the last three just down the middle part. I kind of slide down the brownstone steps because they're badly in need of repair. A rat runs across my foot and it hands me my rent check.
I look, the mailbox is on fire. The mailman is on fire. The fire hydrant, that's where I parked my car. It's a 1994 Volvo 940 Turbo, leather interior, and it has a Tweety Bird seat cover in the passenger seat. Not the driver's seat. But of course, I parked it in front of a fire hydrant, so it's not there anymore. But you gotta love New York, right? So I thought. So I take myself to the subway. Of course, it's flooded all the way up the steps. Flooded with sewage, McFlurry machine runoff, and yesterday's AM New York. I ride a huge boat made of AM New York down the subway, and I get out at East Broadway. I'm ascending the steps, and all of a sudden, I see a man with no face. He spits on me, and I keep going. What a town, what a town. You know, when it rains in New York City, people don't pick up their dog shit. They think, oh, the water's gonna come, just like in the Bible, take all the dog shit away. And then, the Jews will be free. Well, that's not how it works, because I'm still here. I'm still fucking here. Ding dong, ding dong. What's that sound? Is that the Salvation Army man ringing the bell? No, it's 1,000 screws from my abandoned IKEA furniture rattling under the wheels of a Baldor specialty food import truck that's careening down Broadway towards a pigeon in the middle of the sidewalk who's eating a piece of pizza. Where's his day in the sun, BuzzFeed? But you see that pigeon? That's not just any pigeon, no. That was my uncle. Let me tell you how it started. My uncle had a good job. He was the ball boy's ball bag boy for the Brooklyn Cyclones. And one day, 1985, seventh game of the Minor League World Series, which is real, I think. He was bagging those balls left and right. He was the best ball bagger that the ball game had ever seen. They'd call him the ball boy's ball bag boy. And he'd be bagging those balls. Boy, he'd be bagging those balls like a ball boy never bagged balls before. That wasn't until he heard a sound that he felt. He felt the sound in the back of his head. It was pulling his eyes. Like when your retinas detach because you watch too much porno. He had that feeling like a noise in his mind that made his head turn. And who's behind the bullpen? A little old lady. Cute, right? I didn't think they came to baseball games. But you gotta remember, this was 1985. So there was only old women watching baseball games, no one else. But see, she was behind the bullpen, and that's a no-zone for fans. So my uncle, being the pedantic fool that he was, tried to reprimand this woman. He said, ma'am, back in the stands for the fans. The fans can't be in the bullpen, ma'am. What a fucking joke. Because this woman, she was a witch. And then she cursed my uncle right there to live the rest of his days as New York's number one mascot. Not the rat, not the politician, not the little lion statues that's outside of the New York Public Library. No, the pigeon. And he's shitting on cars on Mercedes-Benz from Bensonhurst to Yonkers. I bet you're wondering, where do I come into all of this? Well, it's not so simple of a story, you see. Everybody seems to have something in this town, but me, I got nothing. I'm alone, you know? My uncle lost his life that day, doomed to live as a pigeon for the rest of his days. And what did I lose? I lost 2 pairs of glasses that I got during a BOGO Black Friday sale from Lens Crafters. BOGO means buy one, get one, but now I got none, so what now? I need those glasses. I want to try one of the new lifestyle bowls from the Chipotle menu, and I can't read the fucking menu. But New York's the greatest city in the fucking world, right? So what's my problem? Man, I wish I fucking knew. This town just hasn't been the same anymore. Ever since I moved here in 2015. It's a real bad place.
Spike, Einbinder, everybody. Why don't you take a seat? Wow. Wow. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Stay on.
I'm not sure.
No.
Oh.
No, it's not.
There's a switch.
Figures.
They want to silence us. They want
to.
They want to silence us. Figures.
Silence is gold.
Then why can't I pawn it off at the shop, huh? I need to make rent. If silence is so golden, they should be giving me $200 so I can give my fucking landlord, who is a cockroach that wears a tank top, be able to give him the rent that way.
We love New York City.
We love New York City.
If we didn't like it,
we'd leave. I don't like to talk about this, but
yo.
Yeah. I just want to know, you can keep a secret, right?
Sometimes.
All right, well, see if you can hold on to this hot coal for me. I'm from Los Angeles. All right, yeah. And I'm from Los Angeles, okay? That's why I look like this. It's so much plastic surgery to be blonde, tan, and Aryan. But I digress. It's why it's so hard for me to fit in here, because everyone clocks me as a surfer boy from LA.
Yeah, you look the part, I think.
Fun. My daddy took my fucking T-Bird away.
Do you agree with this statement that L.A. is shitty heaven and New York is fun hell?
And Ohio's purgatory, baby. I've seen it all. I've only been to three states. California, New York, and Pennsylvania.
What does that make Maryland?
What?
Maryland?
I don't know what that is.
Oh.
It's kind of like New Jersey.
Yeah, okay.
All right, I think I heard of it. I know what you're talking about.
It's like a mix between New Jersey and Pennsylvania.
Oh, so like a golden doodle.
Yeah.
like an abomination.
It's squiggly, though.
That's a golden doodle to me. That's what everybody wants nowadays. They want a puppy they can post a grid.
Have you seen The Wire?
The Wire?
Mm-hmm.
You mean the one that's puppeting our fucking mayor?
No.
Whoa.
Got him on these strings. Got him doing the bidding.
No.
What the fuck, you cops? That Wire?
No. Like Lance Reddick?
No, I didn't Reddick.
Idris Elba.
I don't
the TV
know.
Show HBO.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Wait, Idris Elba's in The Wire? I didn't know that. I'm not kidding.
God, I'm old.
Huh?
I'm old. I remember watching that when it came out.
I was around when it came out. I didn't see it.
Fair.
I haven't seen it.
So I'm going to put that on my Hulu to watch playlist.
But yeah, that's Maryland.
I'm going to add to playlist.
Okay.
The Wire, that's Maryland.
Well, we do love New York, right? And you think our great mayor is doing a fantastic job, right? We really like what the mayor's doing.
Mayor Eric Adams, if you're watching this right now, turn it off and look out your window. And stay looking all night, because you got a Christmas present coming early for you. I'm actually having crazy deja vu right now.
Well.
And it's really bad, and I'm scared. There's no way, but it's not done. Okay, you gotta say something now, or else it's gonna be bad time.
Well, this is kind of a weird segue, but it's time to check in with what Eric Adams has been up to. Let's do the Mayor Watch.
Enjoyment of life as we watch everything from jugglers to tightrope artists to famous clowns that do the entertainment that keeps us smiling.
Where are you? Show yourself!
Eric Adams had a very busy week this week with the Adams administration announcing that they will begin involuntary hospitalizing New Yorkers they deem to be mentally unstable in an effort to sweep the streets and subways of those the mayor deems undesirable. This move will leave thousands of man on the street content creators out of a job. Adam says it's a moral issue and must take steps to address what he calls a crisis. Let's hear what he had to say.
I know some people may look at what we're doing saying that we are trying to do something to take away the right of people. No, we're not. The right is that people should be able to live in dignity. This policy has been confirmed in written guidance from our state office of mental health. That is just so irresponsible that we know that this person is about to probably go off the edge and harm someone, but we're gonna wait until it happens. Not in this administration.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Wow.
I don't really have a joke for it. I just think that's really fucked up. What do y'all think about it?
That was so intense that it made part of the set fall apart.
Yeah,
yeah.
I mean, that's
I think it's just a poorly made set.
This set would be locked up and institutionalized by Eric Adams. if he walked in here.
I mean, it's pretty clear that, you know, his solution to the gentrification problem is build concentration camps.
Absolutely, right? That's the only
way. That's what he wants to do, you know. He wants to clean up the streets. But he doesn't want to use the correct tools. He's the long arm of the law. He's trying to put these people in the fucking, in the Roach Motel, but for human beings.
You mean Rikers Island?
Yes. That's, I'm always, you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think he's a really cool guy. I've been admiring him for a really long time. He has some really cool images online. If we take a look. This is Eric Adams hanging out with Mark Anthony.
What's wrong with their wrists?
Sharing the power of stones with my brother Mark Anthony. Cool.
Oh my God. So this motherfucker loves British classic rock too.
Yeah. And here's the only time Eric Adams has actually ever looked cool, with the mayor of Madrid. See, now that's a fucking cool
guy.
I
knew Bill Gates didn't die.
Take a minute to process
Man,
that
motherfucker.
One. Well,
the president of Madrid. Okay. Why don't you look at his phone? All right. Why don't you look at the guy's phone?
I've always been partial to Barcelona.
Yeah, I mean, we love Barcelona, don't we, folks? Yeah, absolutely. You know, there is one point that I do have agreement with Thymeron, which is his stance on veganism. You know, he's been called out a lot for having fish here and there, and I think he says, you know, it's about patterns, and as long as you're eating generally in a better, you know, kind of more healthy standpoint, that it's better for all of society. Would you agree?
What?
Oh, okay.
He identifies as a vegan?
Right, right.
But then eats fish.
It's kind of non-binary of him, isn't it?
Whoa. So it's like a vegan spectrum.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, he is kind of a health nut. Let's watch him make one of his favorite beverages.
Hey, Brooklyn, good morning. You know, just finished exercising. This is my little workout space here. I got my little bench here where I exercise. And now I'm going to show you what I eat in the morning after I work out. So this is my morning drink. This is how I get started. Some cacao powder. I never pronounce it right, but that's the way you spell it. My staff gets on me all the time.
That's my old apartment. I was evicted from there.
Yes.
And I love this stuff.
So that he could make
Moringa
a fucking juice press powder. Fucking knockoff
First,
smoothie?
I take a
cup of berries. You could do whatever berry you want. Oh, wow. Sometimes throw them in.
Lost
the,
a couple there.
Throw them in the Nutribullet with a handful of kale. Just stuff that stuff right in there. A
lot of kale.
This is the real secret. That green, green.
Okay, so it's already completely full at this point.
Two tablespoons.
Imagine
that's
living somewhere for 10 years.
For those of you who didn't have home economics.
For not paying rent. What is and
doors.
You watch this guy fucking cosplay
and
being a Jamba Juice executive.
Nice teaspoon.
In the kitchen where you had
and
to
then
give
one
yourself
teaspoon.
Your own appendectomy.
Put that in there.
After losing the Coney Island hot dog eating contest.
Tablespoon.
Imagine
and
what kind of trauma that brings
spoon.
Up for an individual.
And
then you got an idea what I'm going
yep,
through
tablespoon.
Right now.
These are all good. If you go online and
a lot of powder in
all
this
of these
smoothie.
Powders,
just, get
this
a
is
nice
also
fine
just
kind
really
of chalky.
Good stuff. You should look this up and you'll see just
yeah,
how
piggies love slop.
Healthy this is.
Is this like so on Instagram? Or something?
This is on his YouTube channel when he was
last
borough
time
president.
Many of you said
so,
I had a message
yeah.
on the top. So I'm not gonna give you
this guy's huge on Periscope.
Me about how's that?
It's always
then
on Periscope.
Take a look.
It's always on Periscope.
I feel like selling drugs.
Keep that powder in. You
yeah.
want a lot of kale in here. As,
more kale.
As much green leafy.
There's a maximum fill line on this cup. That
it's small, baby.
He
okay,
is
now you might
wonder.
You
and
might
that's
wonder
just what he's gonna do
what
to
kind
the
of liquid. Okay.
I'm gonna fill it up to about there.
Yummy.
Okay. That's about right. And then
why does he have two outside trash
one,
cans in his kitchen?
Put your top on there. And then all right. Now you could
point.
Top you top the smoothie off with again the items that you
more
need.
Powder.
This is a
wait,
great
more?
Mixture. Great, powerful powders and really healthy stuff. You should look it up. I also
oh, there's more.
Grab a quarter of banana, a slice of apple, slice of mango, a slice of pear, and funny, I would
oh,
even
so we're gonna put
get
these in
a
the
slice
smoothie, right?
Of bell pepper, and then a
you
slice
know, it took,
of
it took
and
hundreds
it's the
of thousands
of
immigrants from
the,
Germany and Russia and Italy
and
to build
drink
the Wonder Wheel to build another Coney
day.
Island
and
beach
me when I tell you,
using Bethlehem
you
steel, 200 tons
all
of
the way into lunchtime.
If they even looked at this smoothie,
start,
all of them would
healthy
die.
Way to start,
we didn't
energy,
need a life
berries,
like this before.
Powder,
you know, people
kale,
would use wheat paste to build their
today.
House and then they would eat it.
I got a full day today.
And no one complained.
We're going to be holding a press
we didn't
conference.
Have vegan, we didn't have crystal. Well, we had crystal, but that was the government who did that. They did that.
To live right,
they
live
did
healthy,
that to
live
us.
Prosperous.
It just makes me sad, you know, like when I came to this town. You know, Chuck E. Cheese still existed. And now where is he? The rat's out of a job. You can't even have a rat. Rats are unemployed in New York City, is what I'm saying. It's a fucking crime.
I feel like he was rejected on MasterChef.
I feel like he won MasterChef. I don't know what you're talking about.
So you love this guy, Kay?
I mean, we all voted for him, right? He won the election. It was a really tough competition. There were a lot of amazing candidates running for mayor.
Yeah, I've been writing in the same guy's name every time I vote. Bud Dwyer, all right?
Fair enough.
All right, we got some bud heads in the back.
We got some bud heads here tonight, everybody.
I'm about to do one of those. I heard this is the first stream ever. I wanted to make it memorable. Hi, Mom. Bye, Mom.
Well, that's been Mirror Watch, everybody. Give it up for Spike, Einbinder. We'll be right back.
Parenting, it's hard. And sometimes you're not really sure if you're doing it right. That's where Parently comes in. Parently is an all-inclusive parenting app with a checklist of daily tasks to take care of your little one. Should I change the baby? Apparently, is it time to give them their lunch? You betcha. As you perform your daily tasks, check them off in the app to earn parenting tokens. The parenting tokens buy keys. What do the keys unlock? You'll see in a sec. Once you've bought three keys, we enter phase two. You now have a fully cognizant, living, breathing baby avatar in the app. This baby avatar is now biologically linked to your baby's heart and brain. Don't worry, this is a good thing. Now when you take care of your IRL baby, or LB, you'll earn tokens for checking them off in the app. But then you can increase your combo multiplier by performing those same tasks for your baby avatar, or TB. Whenever you close the app, never fear, your baby avatar is safe. It's kept behind 12 inches of digital steel. But when you open the app, you're the parent and they're your problem now. If the baby dies in the game, it dies in real life. Listen, I wish it didn't have to be this way, but as long as you're keeping the app baby happy, everything's copacetic. Do you have two babies now? Yes, but are you earning twice the cash you would have if you just had one? Apparently. Now this cash isn't for nothing. You can use this cash to earn all kinds of rewards for your TV. You're gonna want these rewards. Diapers, bottles, rattles, everything your true baby could ever want. But you don't wanna have to wait to earn more pee tokens. Don't worry, we got you covered. Just plug your credit card into the app and you can buy as many tea packs as your little heart can afford.
Yes!
This leads us to the bad news. To save money, we unfortunately gotta turn off the positive reinforcement and token earnings for your LB. You can click them, but the buttons do nothing now. I didn't want to do it, but they told me we have to. Are we running a business here? Apparently. But to make up for this, we've added haptic feedback and even more rewards for your TV, so you can open more crates and unlock even bigger prizes.
Thank you, we're back. I do want to take a moment and talk about some of my activism. Longtime viewers of the show would know that we are fighting the fight for Farrell. And we are going to have Colin Farrell on the show when we complete the fight. And that is the fight that we are fighting. And that is the fight that we will continue to fight, which is the fight for Farrell. And when we win the fight, he will be here on the show. You know, he's here in New York sometimes. He does press tours and there's films and, you know, there's all kinds of different Colin Farrell-based activities here in the city. So when we win the fight for Farrell, right? Okay. Farrell. That's right. We're going to win the fight. He's extremely funny. He's shooting he's filming his next special, Nessun Dorma, at Union Hall this coming week. Please give a warm welcome for Nick Naney, everyone.
Anybody got fucking parents in this room, huh? Get rid of them, huh? The fuck is up with these people? God, hate the parents, hate them. Parents are like the new ISIS, right? Parents are the new, I think I read that in Newsweek, yeah. Parents are the new ISIS. They're awful. Can we get rid of them? Please? Just give me money. What are you doing, you know? Give me the fucking money. You think the suit is in the dollar bin? It's not. Fucking parents. And they're dying? What is going on? They're dying. What is going on? They're dying. You know, it's like, set up an ATM on the gravestone, please. Because I'm trying to get to Six Flags. It's always the one you like more that's dying faster, too. What the? It's like, what is this? Guillermo del Toro's Cabinet of Curiosities? What is this? My life! Like my dad. My dad, my hero, my father! Papa! He's my hero, my dad. He's this Italian rock of a man, my father. My dad is like if Al Pacino and Robert De Niro spit into a dumpster and then that came to life, became sentient, and was an accountant, you know. And he's fucking falling apart! Ah! Comedy! Went to the doctor recently and the doctor, this fucking nerd, was like, I'm like, my dad, what the hell? My dad, I need money. What? My dad, he's Italian. What? And this fucking doctor is like, just looking at the chart, maybe you shouldn't beat the shit out of your dad every week. Fucking stupid fucking nerd didn't get the memo. It's the dream of every little guinea boy to grow up big and strong to beat up your elderly father. Smack him around. Throw him into a tree. I kicked him down the stairs earlier today. He tumbled down like a little meatball. It was adorable. Trying to come between guineas, these nerd doctors. And my mom, the Jew. Ah! What the fuck? Still kicking, the Jew, the mom Jew. God, my mom is like if ISIS was a person, okay? That's basically my mother. I know what you're fucking saying. He hates women. I know, you're gonna blog it later and ruin my life. Well, listen, open your fucking ear hearts and listen. Once I tell you this story about my mom, you're gonna make this noise. Oh, I should have listened. I should have listened before I ruined his life. Listen to this story. I'm at Best Buy. Last week, I'm at Best Buy. Trying to get Transformers 4, trying to get it. I go in there, they got Transformers 1, they got Transformers 2, they got Transformers 3. No Transformers 4, what is this, China? What are you doing? So I text my mom, I'm like, pick me up. I couldn't find the thing, pick me the fuck up. I go outside, I'm waiting for 2 minutes. 2 minutes in the blistering cold. She pulls up finally in her fucking minivan, right? I get in there. Are there chicken McNugs? No. Are there Skittles? No. Nothing to fucking munch on. And then, get this. She turns around and she says to me, oh no, did they not have your movie CD? It's a fucking Blu-ray, you bitch! God! Ah! I mean, if I was like John Travolta, I'd be like, oh, what the? I don't know. I'm trying to write a joke about it. Jesus. I don't know. Fuck. Anyways, I'm Nick Naney. Please come on my special recording. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow. Thank you so much for being here, Nick.
Oh, man. Yeah. Jeez. Well, you know, I'm not super happy to be. I mean, thank you for having me. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Wow, Kay. Right. What an honor. Brooklyn, New York. Yeah. Hey, Spike. How are you? Good to see you. What's up, Chelsea Clinton? How you doing?
Oh, I'm the other one. I'm the other one.
Big fan. Loved you in the Beavis and Butthead movie. Yeah. Anyways, like I was saying.
It's a good movie.
It's a good movie.
At least I have a career.
What's that?
At least I have a career.
Oh, you got me. You got me. You hear that? That's good. Yeah, how you doing? How's it going?
I'm great. You know, we're doing this show. It's going pretty well so far, I think, right? You're having a good time. Everyone's having a good time. Okay. The stream, we're still online, apparently. So, great.
Oh, good.
We're all good, yeah.
What's the view count? What are we looking
that's
at?
A good
50.
Wow.
That's good.
That's amazing. 70.
Hey. Wow. Oh. There we go.
Line go up.
There are more people in this room than there are watching the stream right now.
Wow.
That's actually true.
That's beautiful.
Man, you are mean. But I'm loving it. I'm loving it. I really am. I'm really loving it. Yeah.
Hey, you said something about a blackout period.
Okay, God.
Understand.
We're gonna go into this?
Well, I mean, what better time?
Okay, well, all right. Yeah, I'm doing my special on Thursday at Union Hall. Everybody should come. And
we love Union Hall, folks.
We love Union Hall, folks.
We love Union Hall.
There he is.
Some of the biggest columns we've ever seen, blocking your view.
They're
blocking your view.
That's a funny voice.
We're gonna knock them down, folks. We're gonna knock them down.
What kind of? It's a weird. It's like a funny voice.
Yeah.
It's like Oscar the Grouch.
They're not load-bearing columns, folks. I'll tell you
it's
that.
Like Lorne Michaels.
Like, yeah.
Lorne Michaels.
Lorne Michaels.
I think.
Oscar the Grouch. Kind of
like
Louis Armstrong.
Yeah.
It's a strong New York voice.
Yeah. Strong New York voice.
Just a character I've been working on.
Yeah.
That's good. That's really good.
Anyways, I did ask politely that I sent an email to most comedians saying I would appreciate a blackout period for the week before and after my special. Don't do a show. You know, that's what I mean, you booked me. That's nice. You know, that's real. 5 minutes. That's great.
Overbooked like a fucking airline.
Yeah, exactly. Chelsea Peretti over here. She's got it going on in spades, you know. But so I would have, you know, I asked you, don't do the. I said, don't do it. Don't do it, Kay. Don't do it. You know.
I do remember this now.
Yeah.
Well, suck my dick.
That's
good. I'm just kind of wondering. Okay. You said you did an email to some Brooklyn comedians. I wasn't on the email.
Oh, no. Wait, what's your, is it Spike, what is your email? Is Spike funny, or what is it? Or I think I put it Spike funny, the funny, yeah. Right? Is that it?
That's, okay, that's my old email.
Oh, man.
That's on my MailChimp server.
Ah, I gotta yell at my assistant. Eric! Eric! He's gonna fix it. Yeah, sorry about that. Jeez. But you know, it's very important, this special.
You've been doing a lot of preparation for it.
I've been doing so much.
What goes into preparing for a special like that?
You know, just kind of going to Best Buy a lot. Just seeing what kind of 4K Blu-rays they have, you know.
And it's important to have like a specific kind of media center set up that can really take advantage of the 4K.
Yeah.
Improve, you know.
Yeah.
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 What kind of DVRs?
Well, so I have an Apple TV and I enjoy it, but I don't have the 4K one. So now every time I go and watch something, I have to be like, oh, is there like, what if it's in 4K? So then I have to exit it and then go on the smart TV version of the same app and see if there's a 4K version, and there often is.
Oh, man.
Talking
nice.
And meanwhile, you're 1K. Meanwhile, your 1K, hit the fucking thing.
I'm only,
hit the thing,
I can only
hit the
do
thing,
so much.
Hit the thing.
Wait, is
yeah.
it 1080p?
It's 1080p, it's 4K, 1K, DVR. Meanwhile, people are fucking coughing here like they got TB.
Oh, yeah.
This shit's fucking insane. I just want one letter. That's it. Just one letter. And nobody wants to fucking use the mail anymore. So there's not going to be a letter, of course. And that's why there's no
Quick,
more
be
people.
Real.
Oh my God, it's time to be real. I just sold my data the other day. I sold my facial recognition data, and I didn't know that that meant that I only can have a face for one more week.
Oh.
Right.
Yeah. So
right.
After
what are you going to what are you going to do? Are you going to take it out?
Wow. No, I'm going to switch my face with Lisa Lampanelli. I figure I mean it'd be a close kind of proximity yeah. and that would be okay.
Preparation
she's
goes
dead.
Into swapping your face with Lisa Lampanelli.
Yeah, she's dead. After this happens, she's dead.
Right.
She's not
dead. Oh. So Ooh. Not like face
You're
off.
You're gonna take it off, chimp style?
It's up to the government, you know. They're working the with the AI
well,
people.
I had to pay NYU Langone a lot of money to do that.
So. hey, that's I go there.
Yeah, I got my consult.
Fucking cheers, right?
I got a consult there in 24 months. They're gonna tell me to fuck off in 24 months.
as is their right.
Yeah. I haven't waited that long for someone to put their hand inside me, but okay, I'll do it for NYU Langone.
Wait, what?
Which
gynecologist?
Oh, that's so nice of you.
Or proctologist.
Thank you. Yeah, let's do the universal hole.
All right, there we go.
It's all good. I mean, the business card says Dr. Jekyll, but I think it was more of a Mr. Hyde situation. but they don't make a surgery for me yet because I'm trying to become like a mythical creature.
Ooh, like a griffin?
Like a griffin, like a Lois, like
oh,
a Brian.
Oh, come on. Oh, my God.
All right, everybody. Thank you so much.
Wow. Jesus. What a way to go out, am
that
I right?
Incredible.
Well, we all know that in the Brooklyn comedy scene, a big element and a big part of our culture is drinking alcohol.
Oh, my. Every night. Yeah.
How many drinks did you say you go through in a night?
On a.
You know what? Don't answer that.
Yeah. Yeah. Eric would know. Eric! Eric! Fuck, where is he? Yeah.
But you like a stiff drink before and after your set.
Oh, yeah.
So we've started you off strong.
Yeah. I gotta get drunk so I don't kill myself.
Right.
I mean, you know, that's, you know, so.
Of course.
To do comedy, I gotta be pretty loaded. You know, otherwise I'm bringing a gun on stage, put it in the mouth, you know. The old Budge Wire.
Well, how about we make some delicious beverages together tonight?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Are you ready?
Let's do it.
It's time to play Kaye's Cocktail Challenge.
Let's do it.
All right. Let's play the game. For this game, we are going to need one volunteer from our studio audience. No, yeah.
Check 1, 2, check. All right, is she coming? Okay. Hi, welcome to the game. Nick, you want to get behind me here? So we're just getting situated with this here. Our lovely crew has set this up. Hi, what is your name?
Kate,
thank you so much for being here. If you want to hold on to this.
Sure.
So you're going to need two hands, but I'm also going to need you to hold this. And Nick, you know, here. You're the guest. I can help you out here.
Okay, great.
What do I do?
You want to watch?
Okay.
I thought we went over this before the show. I guess
no,
we did.
I just showed up.
See, this is cool. I can go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. All right, so as you can see here, we do have an incredible selection of mixers and beverages. And why don't we get started?
Looks like Tuesday afternoon to me.
Absolutely. All right. Do we have any ice? Is there ice in that freezer over there? A couple ice trays? No, it didn't. It didn't freeze. It should be in there.
Eric!
Oh! Oh my God. They're not frozen. You know what? Bring them over anyway.
Bring
them
over. Come on.
Oh, that's real good shit right there.
Some
yeah.
Some of them are a little bit.
Beautiful. Can we get a shot of that here? That's. Alrighty. All right, why don't we start us off here?
Okay.
So we're going to pour ourselves a stiff glass of water into our tumbler glass here. So sharing is caring.
Sharing is caring.
Yeah.
No, I agree. Sharing is caring.
Yeah, yeah.
Sharing is communism.
Just the two. Just the two.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, it's okay.
God damn it.
All right, why don't we cool this drink down and add a little bit of ice to it here? Don't be shy. Now, you can't make her drink for you, Nick.
You can't make her drink for her.
Oh, wait,
you gotta.
Is that her drink?
Yeah, you gotta.
My drink. I gotta do it. Okay.
Okay, yeah. Cool.
Now, the point of this game, I should probably explain the rules of the game first. The
point. Good, yeah.
The point of the game is once you make the beverage, you need to actually swap.
Swap the drinks.
Yeah, not this first one.
Okay.
But after that, we'll do it. All you know, right. And actually, forget that rule. I don't think that's going to work. Sorry.
Live TV, huh?
Right. I'm kind of realizing this right now as we're going through this. You know it's going to be archived afterwards, right? So,
I mean, maybe.
All right.
That's it.
So we've cooled our drink down. I think it's cool enough. Why don't we take the ice out?
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Not so easy, is it?
It's kind of easy.
All the ice. Let's take it out.
I got it out.
Can I put it back in the tray? For safe
no.
I'm sorry.
All right. So let's add a delicious, about a half a shot of our incredible rye whiskey here, our Jack Daniels.
Sharing is caring. I don't know what you want me to say. What do you want me to say? I need this open right now so I don't fucking. Yeah, I'm trying to fucking open it. Jesus. There we go.
Just a half a shot there.
Yeah, that's half a shot.
All right. All right, now let's drink that.
Okay. One.
Just drink it.
Cheers.
How's that taste?
Oh, it's fantastic.
Goes down good, right? All right, let's move on to our next drink. So we love natural wine here. We love natural wine. We got a delicious bottle of natural wine here. So why don't we just top off our wine glasses here with a little bit of that amber wine.
Natural wine. That's natural wine. That's natural wine.
Thank you. All right, let's add a little bit of kick to this. So
yeah.
Let's add a few dashes of delicious Kikkoman soy sauce to the drink.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Don't be shy.
Yeah. That's
Kikkoman.
This is one of my favorite beverages for autumn.
It's good for you that way, right?
All right, bottoms up. Really, really opens up the sinuses, doesn't it? How's that feel?
Good for the heart.
Oh, I loved it.
Yeah.
It was great.
All right. Absolutely delicious.
Can I get
get some rice? Just kidding. I'm fucking. Can I get some rice? Because I drank soy sauce. Get it? Come on, laugh! Yeah.
All right. I think it's time for our final drink of the evening. So we have some delicious warm apple cider here. It's, you know, the holidays are coming up, right? So
yeah, no, it's true.
Yeah. Jingle all the way.
So let's you can use your tumbler glasses again.
Okay.
You got to be rapid with this. You know, come on, let's go. Sorry. We got to get it moving. There's a lot of show to get to, folks.
No.
Hurry the fuck up, Nick.
You gotta keep that cider warm.
Just a little bit. There you go. There you go. Keep it going. Keep it going. Keep it going. All right. Now let's continue with another quarter shot of our delicious rye whiskey. Just a quarter shot there. All right. Let's continue. Let's get a delicious quarter shot of our gin.
Gin for the win.
Now let's get a delicious quarter shot of our tequila.
Tequila will heal you, baby. That's for you, Nicky boy.
All right. Now, because it is the winter time and it is the holidays, we want to make sure that we get a nice, hearty, delicious... But full rounded flavor here.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go ahead and add a shot of our melted butter to the drink. Mmm. All right. You know what? Actually, let's go ahead and add our second shot of melted butter to the drink here. You know what? Let's add a little more of that natural wine to our beverage here as well.
That's natural wine.
All right, let's spice it up a little bit. How about a sour punch straw?
Yeah.
You have we have strawberry and apple.
December 8th. December 8th, Union Hall.
Beautiful.
Shows 7:30 and 10 o'clock. Yeah.
Are tickets still on sale?
Tickets are still on sale.
So it's not sold out?
It's never going to be sold out.
All right.
Plenty of seats. Plenty of seats.
You know, I think we could use a little bit of citrus here. So why don't we get a lime squeeze in there? We've got our knife here. Be careful.
Okay. I am putting the mic down.
Gotta bake that butter curdle. Just one more hurdle. Drink it through a sour straw.
Mmm.
Natural wine.
I feel like I'm at a Brooklyn comedy night right now. About to drink this. Feels like I'm at a... Anyways.
Are we done? I think we're... You know what? I don't think this is spicy enough. Let's get our hot sauce packet. Thanks to Popeyes in Louisiana for our hot sauce packets tonight. Beautiful. All right, you know what? It could be a little more boozy, don't you think?
I think so, yeah. I you know, it's a little lightweight for me.
There's room.
Why don't you add one more quarter shot of your choice?
Natural wine.
December 8th.
All right, bottoms up. Woo! Come on, finish the drink. We got him. They're not drinking it fast enough for my money. All right. If it's an emergency, we don't have to finish it. You're good. I think she's okay.
What is going on?
But I think Nick could have another big gulp of that. You need to all go to his fucking show right now. All right. All right. He's had enough. You're drunk. Thank you for playing Kaye's Cocktail Challenge. We'll be right back.
Everything at this point, too. What do I do?
Oh, have you tried everything? Even happy pills?
Can you read it?
Yeah.
Happy what exactly?
Now you feel me.
Happy pills!
Alright.
Oh, pills? Aren't these those things that you can choke on?
No, not with water. Wanna try again?
Yeah. Pills? Aren't these those little things that you can choke on?
No, not at all. As long as you take it with a glass of water, it should be fine.
Happy pills? I mean, come on, you've got to be pulling my leg. There's no way that actually works.
Actually, happy pills are clinically proven to work for the majority of users.
Oh, so I won't feel bad about the recent breakup or death in the family that I've been struggling with recently?
Nope, you won't feel any sorrow at all thanks to happy pills.
That sounds amazing. Are there any side effects I should be worried about?
Not really, except...
I noticed you didn't mention any sexual side effects. Are things still going to be copacetic when it comes to being with my partner in the sack?
Let's just say you're going to want to get good at digital stimulation because of the happy pills.
What about weight gain? Should I be concerned at all about ending up a bit more on the tubby side?
You'll be harder to push over.
Okay, yeah, I think I've made my decision. I'm sold on the psych med. I'm down to take happy pills.
Awesome. Are you ready to give your doctor a phone call? It's a prescription medication.
Cool, all right. Hi, I'm calling to see about setting up an appointment. Yeah, I'm a new patient. Sure. September 23rd, 1991. Kaiser. Mm-hmm. Do you have something, any time during the week, is fine. Do something. Yeah, that totally works. Great. Okay. Thank you.
You idiot. Me and my company are just out to make money.
Seen him performing with Blood Orange on The Tonight Show and at Madison Square Garden, opening for none other than Harry Styles. His record, Acts of Service, is available everywhere. Please welcome Liam Benzvi.
Funny thing that happens when we lose our minds. We look
Lee and Benzvi. Thank you so much. We'll be right back.
This summer, prepare for a story unlike anything you've seen before. Courage. Love. Strength. Bobo, the dog who could legally consent to sex, coming this summer to Disney Plus.
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm just sleeping.
Yeah? Sleeping?
Yeah.
Okay. Well?
Just like everybody else here.
Yeah. Well, you can hear them on the Extremely Funny podcast. You can subscribe on Patreon. Please welcome Patrick Doran, Caitlin Pitts, and Cameron Fetter of Podcast About Lists, everyone.
Hey, Patrick. Hey. Is this off?
It's off. It's off. It's on now.
There's a little Jack Daniels for you there.
Oh.
Where?
Thank
are,
you.
Where are Caleb and Cameron?
Oh shit. No.
You're not gonna drink that.
What? Oh, I would. Were you offering the shot? It was closed. I've lost all privileges
Patrick,
to it. All right.
Patrick, you're a very funny comedian on your own. I would have just billed, just you. I don't understand.
That well, who cares? Who gives a shit?
Cool. I do, regularly.
About?
Number two.
Oh,
I do that regularly.
It's really important to have regularity.
I guess.
So, do you?
You know what? Actually,
fiber.
They did. Caleb and Cameron did send in videos.
Oh, okay.
I guess roll the clip.
Hey there, K-Night Live viewers. I'm sorry I couldn't make it tonight. My family got into a car accident, and so I am down in North Carolina at the hospital. We're hoping that they make it, but hope you guys have a great show. I know it's going to be a good one. Everyone's here is watching Eternal Family. We love Eternal Family. We love Eternal Family. We love Eternal Family, don't we?
Hell yeah.
Oh, hell yeah, we love Eternal Family here at the hospital. Hope you guys have a good show, and I'll catch you next time.
Okay.
And then I think Cameron sent one, too. Oh,
okay.
Hey, guys. Hey, everyone at K-Night Live. Whoa. Sorry. Sorry, I'm actually really busy. Whoa! I'm actually really busy today, so I wasn't able to come through and just... Whoa! Wait, hold on. Whoa!
Whee! That's like a lot of fun.
But I'm sure you guys are going to have a great show. And Pat, you kill it by the... Woo! And just congratulations everybody involved. What? Whoa! Wait, hold on. Whoa, get a little busy. No!
Ah!
I forgot to tell them that this was happening, but now my friend is dead. I came in here with a who cares attitude.
Okay.
So I guess I'm going to have to keep doing that.
I just hope
thank you. I'm going to need this.
I hope he's okay. It looked like he might be okay.
Oh boy. Oh dear. This is too small.
It was a prop.
Look at that.
It was a prop.
That's way too small.
I'm working on a limited budget here.
Took it before they took it away.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for keeping it, because I needed it. Now I'm perfectly fine. I don't care about that guy dying.
Cool. So you all have had great success, right? And,
yeah.
You're kind of, you're dressed really well. Like, you're kind of going
well,
Hollywood.
You know, I don't give a shit about podcasting anymore.
Okay.
Same. I just wore whatever I was wearing today.
I could have sworn that was $1 million suit. Again, I can't see much
Target.
In these glasses.
You also just drank.
That's true.
So, what are you interested in? What are you getting into?
I don't give a shit about podcasting anymore. The thing that I'm interested in is movies.
Okay, we like movies,
yeah.
Right? Movies.
Hey.
Lots of
filmmakers here in the audience tonight.
So for the past 2 weeks, I've been working on this new movie.
Okay. Exciting stuff.
Yeah.
Right?
And, you know, the first thing I did, I've been scouting talent. I've been producing this all on my own wealth. This is all coming out of my own pocket, and I think this is going to be one of the greatest movies you've ever seen. Okay?
I'm sorry, are there tigers on your glasses?
They're little cheetahs, and
little
they're
cheetahs. Okay.
Grabbing at a ball of yarn.
All right.
If you want to get a... I'll turn all right. Aside if you want to get a punch in on that. I bought these for $8 out of a guy who was selling them in a closet.
It's that movie money.
I think I know that guy.
Yeah, he's on what is it? It's Knickerbocker and
yeah, Bushwick.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's around there.
See, she's cool. She knows.
Chelsea knows about Bushwick.
You live in Brooklyn, right?
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know much about Manhattan.
Neither do I. But this first clip we have here, this is somebody I've been scouting a lot of people on YouTube and LiveLeak.
Okay.
And I think this first person is this is from liveleak.com. Sure, we can cut it there.
Yeah.
So that is the theme song to
banger.
My new movie.
Wow. I don't really.
That's the theme song.
It seemed like some older footage there.
Nope.
Okay.
That was made this year.
That was a banger.
All right.
Yeah.
So
you have a great eye for talent.
Hell yeah.
What was it like working on set with all the incredible actors?
It sucked. It sucks currently.
Right.
I have to go in every day, look at these fuckers right in the eye, and tell them, you're all pieces of shit. And if you're not, none of you are doing what I want.
I've been told.
So you're Michael Bay.
So I what?
You're Michael Bay, essentially.
I'm Patrick, but if I get... Look, if I can be Michael Bay.
I'm told we have a clip of the lead of the film you've been
watching. Oh, yeah. We do have a clip of the lead of the film. This is somebody
I
found.
Yeah, baby. You're freaking sexy, baby. Yeah. You're freaking sexy. Can I ask you a question, baby? Do I make you horny? Do I make you randy? Yeah, baby.
And I've never seen something like this in my life. I saw that, and I was like, what the hell is he... Why is he asking me that? Why is he saying this to me? And...
There's something to this.
It made me horny.
Yeah.
It did really? Make me horny. So that's what the main character of my movie is going to be saying. That's what they're going to be acting like the whole time.
Can I make a suggestion?
Yeah.
There be a bus, and if it goes underneath a certain speed limit, like 50 miles an hour, it blows up.
That is one of the most amazing ideas I've ever heard.
Wow.
Our new executive producer, Chelsea Manning.
One project at a time, Patrick. One project at a time.
All right. Okay. Well, I got news earlier that we actually have a trailer finally cut.
We have the trailer.
We have
really
a trailer
exciting
now.
Stuff, people.
We're still in production, but we cut a trailer. I know how to work fast. I know that movie production, it's about speed. It's not about quality. I don't know anything else. I don't know.
That'd be a great name for a film.
I don't know. We don't know about
production. La-da-dee. She just stands there looking for money. She's homeless.
She's homeless.
La-da-dee, la-dee-da.
Tick, tick, tick,
tick. All right, well, here's the trailer
Let's roll
of
the
our
clip.
Movie.
Yeah, baby. No.
That's the same clip from before. That's the same clip from before. There's another one.
There's another one.
There's another clip.
Yeah, baby.
And, nope.
You're freaking sexy, baby. Yeah.
All right.
Technical difficulty.
You know what? Scrub forward a little bit in that video. He does Fat Bastard, too.
Yeah, baby.
It's like, go to, like, I think it's like
number one,
a couple
see?
Minutes in. No, that's Dr. E. There it is.
I'm dead sexy.
That's him being
Look
Fat
at my
Bastard.
Sexy belly. I'm freaking sexy a lot. I haven't seen my feet in 3 years, like, I've got no friends, I've got no family, I've got nobody loves me. Give me my baby black, give me my baby black, I'm dead sexy a lot.
Okay,
so
we don't,
have an actual
do we
trailer.
Have the trailer?
We do have the trailer. $50,000 just for that trailer. $50,000.
That's the trailer for your film. Mm-hmm. Well.
And I'm so lucky I was here to promote this.
Well, I think you've brought a lot of disgrace and shame to this program
what
tonight.
What the hell?
I don't think that's possible.
Huh?
Well, thanks, Chelsea. I really appreciate you saying that. I think you've brought a lot of great energy here tonight, too, okay?
Who brought great energy, me or Chelsea?
Chelsea.
And I'm a piece of shit.
Yeah. So yeah. You don't bring your friends. You don't bring
They had
clips.
Problems.
Okay.
Yeah, baby. You're freaking sexy, baby. Yeah. You're freaking sexy. Can I ask you a question, baby? Yeah. Oh. You want to give me a hug? Could you give Daddy a hug? Ticka, 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 ticka. No? Okay. I'm evil.
All right, all right, all right. Patrick Doran, everybody, thank you so much. Woo! We'll be right back.
Guess that means more bacon for me.
So true. More bacon equals yummy.
Diet Pepsi, hookah, and Gambino in the garage. Hashtag nuff said.
You are my favorite person in the universe.
Hot dog for dinner.
A special meal for an incredible guy.
I want to make a difference in the world.
I need a Joey Dunkleton doll to put on my shelf.
Woke up covered in spider bites. FML.
Oh no. I wish I could shrink you and carry you around in my big stinky bucket.
Please stop.
Wow, so apparently chickens get a disease known as bumblefoot when their foot becomes infected when bacteria enters the chicken's system. Why is literally nobody talking about this?
This lady seriously didn't know about bumblefoot?
We've been talking about bumblefoot for years, you just haven't been paying attention.
Bumblefoot is not just for chickens. I have human bumblefoot, and it worsens every day. It spread to my brain, and I can now speak to the Lord our Savior Jesus Christ. Through his guidance, I have written a sequel to the Bible.
Please give it up for Liam Benzvi.
Thank you.
dark, I feel your resistance. You can see my heart burning in the distance. Baby, 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 I'm your man. You lose your way, just take my hand. You lost at sea, then I'll commend you both to me again. Don't go too far right where you are, that's where I am.
That's our show. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you to Chelsea Manning, Spike Einbinder, Nick Naney. We love it. We thank you. What? Eric Yates.
Boo.
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 What are you doing here?
I'll tell you, you looked right over at me when you said Eric Adams.
I don't think that's fair to say at all.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. You looked right at me. I was in the back, so you went out of your way. And look, I didn't even want to be here. I just agreed to be Nick Naney's assistant for 2 weeks for free.
Listen.
And now I got to clean up his vomit.
You've been causing a lot of problems online for the last couple weeks.
I campaigned against this.
I thought I was actually going to be your sidekick, and then so Chelsea Manning is here.
Can
we
speak
into
the mic?
You told me that I was going to be the sidekick.
You know what? I did say that, actually.
So I just don't know what's going on, actually.
I think this is uncalled for you to come in here and make a scene.
Well, I've just been...
Okay.
And his big talk cut, too.
You are the announcer.
Yeah, well, it didn't play.
Yeah, it did. It did fucking play. It played. It played. It was on the stream.
I came all the way
down. I didn't even hear it.
You think I didn't live close to here? He looks like shit. He's wearing a fucking t-shirt. You think I live near here? You think it takes like...
My Parently video short. There's a whole other half to it.
I'm not the editor of the show.
You're killing me, Kay.
I'm not the editor.
The ending's the best part.
That's a really good video, and she worked hard on it.
And you wanted the two Jews to be your director and producer, and your name is only one letter different from Kanye.
What do you have to say? What do you have to say?
I never thought about that before.
And I know that you literally jerk off to Hitler videos.
This is absolutely ridiculous.
And you're dating
Hold
and
on,
you
hold on.
Kaye.
Chelsea has something to say.
It's fucked up. No.
Wait, what the fuck?
Listen.
What the hell?
Hey! Shane Knight!
On your private Twitter account? On your private Twitter account, you called me slurs. So you
That's
need to work
true.
On your internalized transphobia.
That's not true at all.
Call a lot of people slurs.
And I called myself a slur.
Because?
I don't even know.
And you can. And
your set sucks.
Fuck you, Kay.
And you don't have a boyfriend. We hate Kay. 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 We hate Kay.
Which of these cameras works? Give me a camera. Give me a camera.
That's our show, everyone.
Lauren Michaels! Lauren Michaels, do not let Kay steal your intellectual property! Do not let Kay steal your intellectual property! Do not come!
They cut the whole bit! They cut his whole bit! He was supposed to be the announcer!
Yeah, yeah, fuck, what?
Baba booey.
Hey, fuck you, buddy.
Bye. Goodbye. Don't do this again. Don't do this again.
If anybody knows, I'm just trying to get on the train. Where's the train? Can anybody tell me where the subway is? How to get to the subway from here? I'm trying to get on the subway from here.
Fuck you.
To the subway? I'm trying to get to the subway. This guy's calling me slurs. That's the F to the G? Okay. Okay, no, yeah, the F to the G. Okay.